Well, everyone, Christian here. Did you know color swatches can increase conversion on your product page? It just makes it visually easier for customers to scan your product page. In this video, I'm going to teach you how to add these on the Dawn theme. Dawn is an awesome new Shopify theme. We've already done a few videos on this, so if you haven't checked out our other videos on the Dawn theme, you can do so right here. Now, something that's missing from this theme is the ability to have color swatches in the actual product page. Jotun Digital has come up with a way not only to add these, but add images for patterns. So shout out to Jotun Digital for this guide that we're gonna follow today. So let me just show you real quick here. We have a product that we worked on our last Dawn video, which is the high-waisted airlift leggings. And as you can see here, we have the size bubbles, so small, medium, large. And then we have the color ones, black, white, and bronze. And as you can see, they're just like the same default selectors, right, as the size ones. So you can see black, white, but you can't actually see the color. You just see it by text, essentially. So the first thing that we're gonna do is change a little bit of the code in the back end. So there are two things that we're gonna change in the main product.liquid file and in the base.css file. So let's go into that right now. We're gonna go to our theme here, click on actions, and then edit code. And then we're going to find the main product.liquid. So just type in, oops, main product.liquid, which is this one right here. Okay, and then what we want to do is search for this piece of text right here. So what I did is I think I just typed in option.position and I was able to find it pretty quickly. So I'm going to click on Command or Control F so we can search for text and type that in. And then here we have it. So it goes from label to label, and we're going to delete that and actually add some new code. So we're going to replace it with this right here. So we're going to copy this and then just paste it and then save. And then the next one that we want to do is go to the base.css. And then in this one, all we're gonna do, we're not gonna delete anything. We're just going to add more code to the bottom of this doc. So we're gonna copy all this. And we're gonna scroll all the way to the bottom. Paste, and then click save. Now, before we move on, I just wanna say bienvenidos. My name is Christian Pinon, one of the co-founders here at Branding. We're an e-commerce growth agency that specializes in helping clothing stores grow and scale profitably online. We drop new videos every week, so make sure that you hit that subscribe button and turn on notifications. Okay, so next step after adding the custom code is to create the meta field. So let's go into our settings to create those right now. So we're gonna go to settings, and then you scroll down to the bottom, and you'll see meta fields right over here. And then for this particular scenario, if you're following along some of these videos, you know that we've done a couple of things with meta fields, but we've done a lot of things within the products section, right? So in this example, we're gonna add variant definitions. So we're gonna click on variants, and then in here, we're gonna add definition. The first one's just gonna be color. So let's do color. And then the namespace and key, we're gonna change it to say color swatch. This has to be that way so that it works well with the code that we just added. And then on the content type for this one, we want to make sure that we select color. Color will allow you to just do the full spectrum of colors, and you can also add the hex code. So if you have a very specific hex code for a special product, then you can just add that hex code right within the product variation. Okay, we're going to click save on that. But now we also want to go a step further and we want to do images. So there may be some products that are not just as simple as black and white. So I have an example of a flannel shirt, right? So flannel shirts have just designs, right? Sure, it may have a main color, like a red or a white, but we also want to appreciate some of that texture and some of the design, right, of that flannel shirt. So what we're gonna do is we're gonna do a different definition, and we're gonna call this one image. And then this one's gonna be image.swatch. And then for this one, we're going to do a URL. We're going to keep everything else the same. Click save. Yeah, hey. I want to let you in a little secret. We're using a tool called Triple Whale for all of our clients. And this powerhouse of a tool. It allows you to see the lifetime value of a customer at 30, 60, and 90 days. But what we're most excited about is the estimated action of customers. Imagine being able to send out emails or even run some ad campaigns to customers who are actually likely to buy from you a second or third time, and actually knowing when to send out these marketing messages. This tool is super, super powerful. It allows you to connect everything together in one place, one dashboard, so you can grow your business a lot easier. So make sure you check out the description link below. All right, so now that we have the custom code, we've added the meta fields, I think what we have next is to actually add some products with those swatches. So let's go to products and let's go add a product here. The first one that we have is going to be a men's short sleeve perfect t-shirt. And I do believe I have some, some images. So let's just add these two. Upload. Let's make these $10. And then this product has options, and we're gonna do color. And then let's do black, blue, white. Let's just add some quantity so it doesn't show it's sold out. Click save. All right, and then let's click on, actually, let's just activate that product on our store. And then click on view so we can see how that looks right now. So black, blue, and white. So as you can see, nothing has changed because we haven't necessarily assigned the meta fields right now. So we have the custom code in place, but we still have to assign the meta fields. So if we go back over here, you'll see that right here, we have all the old meta fields that we've added from some of our previous videos. But in order to change the meta field for the variants, as you can see, they don't show up here within the main product page. You see, you complete the look, you see the size chart and all the other things, but you don't see the actual color and image that we just added. And that's because you have to go individually into the actual variant. So you click edit here. And when you scroll down, you can see the meta fields for image and color right here. So for this particular one, we have black. So we don't have necessarily any hex code colors. We're just gonna wing it here, but black usually is right over there in that corner. Click on save. And then blue, we're gonna do somewhere along there. That looks nice. Save. And then white, it's gonna be on the other opposite corner of black. Click save. All right, so there we have all the color swatches selected. We're gonna go back to our product page and refresh that. And as you can see, now we have the circle color swatches with the black, blue, and white. Looks very, very nice. Now, the next example that I wanna give you is to do that kind of like a flannel design type shirt and seeing how that looks. So let's go and go back over here, add another product. And this one is a poplin long sleeve button down shirt. I do believe I have a couple of images for that, maybe just one. Yep. And then let's do this one, $10 as well. Very cheap shirts. This product has options. We're gonna do color as well. Now, the colors are Allure Blue and Beam. Let's add a couple of quantities here, and then let's click on edit. Oh, actually, let's click save first. Hey, if you're enjoying this video so far, please consider hitting that like button. Really appreciate that. All right, so we have our product page added here. Now let's click on edit, and then we have the Allure Blue. So instead of clicking on the color, we're gonna do image. Now, for the image, what we did was a URL. So what we need to do here is actually go to settings. So I'm gonna open this in a new tab just so we don't lose our space there. And then inside of settings, you can go to files and we're gonna upload files. And here we have both of them. So what you wanna do is basically have a perfect square image. of whatever texture you want to use. So for example, if you have tie-dye shirts, you can use that. If you have heathered type t-shirts, you can use an actual square, small square image, and it will take automatically care of making it circle. So let's see where they're at. Okay, there we go. So we have this one, so let me copy this link. And what we want to do here is, nope, not in color, for the URL. We just paste the link in there, click save. And then for the beam blue, we're gonna go over to the other one, click that button to copy the link, go back over here, scroll all the way to the bottom, and then for the image URL, we're gonna paste that in there, click save. All right, and then let's go back and activate this one as well so we can see how it looks. Click view. All right, and there we have it. So as far as the colors, instead of actually showing a full hex code color swatch there, we have those images, again, being cut out in a circle manner. So it just looks a little bit nicer. And you have a more visual, better visual experience, right, when you're shopping for these products. Again, that's all we have for today. It's just a quick video on how to add these color swatches and image swatches to your product page using the Dawn theme. Obviously, this might not be the perfect solution, right? There's a couple of few steps, extra steps that you have in there. But again, it's something that it will help you in the long run with customers are shopping on your store and they're looking for these swatches. It just makes this experience a little bit nicer and easier. If you like this video, make sure that you check out our rest of the videos on the Dawn theme that we made. See you on the next one.